Very good morning to all the students. This is Veena teacher. I hope all of you are safe and fine. Children, today we're going to start with taxonomic hierarchy. Now, according to the taxonomic hierarchy, the first level of classification that you can see here on the screen is domain, followed by kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and the last one is species. Now here, species is, as all of you know, it is the members that are present in the species, they are able to interbreed amongst themselves to produce a fertile offspring. And species is considered to be the lowest and basic taxonomic category. So now, this taxonomic hierarchy, that is, hierarchy means ranking one after the other, represents the unit of classification. Now, these taxonomic groups or categories are distinct biological entities and not merely morphological aggregates. Okay, so here, this particular order will be followed whenever we are classifying any organism under specific category. Now let us understand these terms one after the other. The first term here that you're seeing is domain. Now if you remember, we have seen three domains of life, that is bacteria, archaea, eukaryota, or in the terms that we studied, that is archaebacteria, eubacteria and eukaryotes. Now this is the highest rank of organisms, and these three domains, as we have already discussed, these were designed by Carl Ues in the year 1990. So the taxonomic ranks should always be capital letters. Okay, now we will see about the rules and regulations of naming the organism slightly later. So the domain is the first rank. So whichever organism you are discussing, you are going to identify, first you have to ensure whether this is belonging to bacteria or archaebacteria, or whether it is a eukaryote. Now, after understanding that, let us go to the next level, that is known as kingdom. So, kingdom happens to be the highest classification after domain into which living organisms are grouped. Now, at present, there are five kingdoms. Now, these five kingdoms are Animalia, Plantae, Fungi, Protista and Archaebacteria, or we can say this as bacteria. So, here, all the living organisms are present in one of these five categories. Anyways, in the future modules, we are going to study about the general characteristics of each of this kingdom. So, I will not discuss about it right now. But understand that each and every organism is put under any one of these five kingdoms. The next is phyla. Phylum or phyla is grouped next level after kingdom in the biological classification. The purpose of this level is to find some physical similarities among various organisms within a kingdom. So, for example, in the animal kingdom, there are 35 phyla present. Okay, now the different phylums are Arthropoda, Porifera, Chordata, all these you have studied in your lower classes. As an example, I just put them. All these are phyla. Next comes class. The organisms of a phylum are further divided into various classes. The classes were the most common rank proposed by Linnaeus. These are about, there are about 108 different classes in the kingdom Animalia. Okay, and then for example, as an example, I have put a few classes here under animal, that is aves, where birds are seen, and mammalia, and class Reptilia, etc. Next comes order. The organisms of a particular class are further distributed into orders. It is much more accurate than classes. So there are about 18 to 25 orders in a class. So Mammalia is a class. In the class, further the orders are present. Okay. Now, for example, in the Mammalia class, the orders are, few orders are kept here on the slide. You can see them on the slide. Primates, Chiroptera, Carnivora. These are all various kinds of orders that are present in class Mammalia. Now further when we go, we have family. After classification of organisms into orders, next we have family. Okay, it is the 8th major taxonomic rank and there are 12 families in order Carnivora. So here in the previous slide, I told you that the Carnivora is an order. So in the Carnivora, there are 12 families present. Examples are Canidae, Ursidae, Felidae, etc. Next comes genus. You are familiar with genus. The genus or genera. It is even more specific compared to family or other groups. Genus is the first part of organism's scientific name using binomial nomenclature. And second part is the name of the species. The scientific name of an organism is always italicized. That is, it is written in italics. Followed by the genus name, which should be capital letters. Both genus and species are the only taxonomic rank that are present or that are written in italics. For example, here you have an example as Homo sapien. You can see that Homo sapien letter, the two words Homo and sapiens are written in italics. So whenever you see italics in the printed text matter, you can understand that we are talking about a particular scientific name of an organism. Now, in this Homo sapiens, the Homo word denotes genus and sapiens means species. And in the last line, you can see that the Homo sapiens here, it is underlined. So whenever, remember this, that whenever you're writing Homo sapiens with your handwriting, since we cannot write in italics, you have to underline, which will give an indication that we are talking about the scientific name of an organism. And you can see H is capital, S is small. This is genus and this is species. So I have one more example of binomial nomenclature here, Magnifera indica. It is the name of mango. Now when you're writing in your normal handwriting, you have to write Magnifera M capital, indica I small letter, and they have to be underlined separately. Remember, they have to be underlined separately. When you're having this in a printed text form, you need not underline, but it should be written in italics. M indica, for example, if you don't remember the name of the genus, then yes, the genus, at least the letter can be mentioned, and writing indica here, this also will help you to understand that we are talking about the genus Magnifera and the species indica. Otherwise, if at all still you cannot remember the name of the genus, then you can write Magnifera, that is the whole Magnifera, and you can omit the species indica. That also is acceptable. Now here, coming to the species, the members of the species interbreed freely and produce a fertile offspring. Species is the last and major taxonomic rank, which are subdivided into subspecies. Okay. Now here, there are 8.7 million species that are present on Earth. Now here, you see, okay, one interesting thing which I would like to say is, Solanum is the name of the genus. Okay. And here you see, Solanum, Melongena, it is brinjal. Solanum, Tuberosum, it is potato. Okay, so you can understand the difference between a brinjal and a potato. So that is the specification we are talking about when we are discussing about the classification. So in some way or the other, brinjal and potato are related to each other, because of which they are put at the same genus, that is Solanum. So maybe when you see the flower, or when you see the structure, internal structure of brinjal and potato, there will be certain kind of similarity because of which they are put under the same genus. But nevertheless, since they are very different from each other, brinjal and potato, that is bengal and aloo, they are so different from each other, they are put under different kinds of species. That's it, children, all of you. Thank you all. Stay safe, children. God bless you all.